everybody. Welcome to Milt's Comics. I'm Milt, and this is my co-host, Marissa, my daughter-in-law-to-be. Marissa, big news today. Yesterday, we got a bunch of books in from CGC. I got the first box right here. I'm not sure what's in it. It could be either my Silver Age books, some Bronze Age books, or a bunch of modern books. Personally, everything that's modern, I think we should get in the nines at least. Lucky, if we're good, we got a 9.8. The bronzes, I was just in the process about 1984 of putting them in Mylar bags. So anything before 1984, I gotta hope I get an 8. An 8.0 would be great. The Silver Age books before 1970 or so, I was a kid, I was buying them off the spinner racks. I hope on those to get a 6, 7. That would be great. But I'm not sure, I haven't checked, so let's open up the box. I've already used my trusty knife on this one. Let me get this crap out of here.
I wonder what we have.
Good question. Well, Marissa, why don't you do... Let's see what we have.
All right. Let's see. Oh, wow. Look at this. Out of all the things I wasn't expecting, we have The Simpsons in here. That's one of my favorites.
I must say, I love The Simpsons. I don't believe this book has any value at all, but it's one of those shows that I've always loved. And what this tells me is the rest of these books, they've got to be modern. So they should all be fairly high grades, I would hope.
Let's see what we got here, Milt.
Yes.
We got a 9.8 on this one. No shocker there.
I still can't understand why. I mean, this book, in all honesty, is... it's damn near perfect. They just don't give out 9s, 9s, and 10s, I guess. But I love the, there's the front, of course. I love the book on the back as well. It's a classic Simpson flip.
Wasn't expecting that one.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite shows, so.
Okay, Marissa, let's, what do we have next?
Let's see what we got.
Let's make this quick.
Alright. Next up we have Ultimate Fallout. First appearance.
Okay. This is Ultimate Fallout. You're right. This is the first appearance of Miles Morales, but this is this is the second printing variant, which is the first time his face is shown on the cover. This was in great shape.
Yeah, it looks really good.
Yeah, so what's this?
I'm hoping for a 9.8 again. Let's see. Yeah, that's what we got.
Yeah, that's...
it's in near-perfect shape. I don't know how much better you can get than that.
I actually like this better than the Ultimate Fallout 4 first print cover myself.
It's a good one.
But we shall see. Okay, what's next?
All right, let's see.
So far, so good.
Yeah, we're having 9.8s.
I picked them pretty good this
time.
All
right, oh, here we go. Wonder Woman.
Again.
Can't go wrong.
I just love the cover.
Oh, yeah.
It's a simple cover.
Old meets new.
I did have this pressed because there, you know, was pretty wavy coming from the printer straight from here.
Looks really good to me. It's meant to look old, but I think it's in good shape. Let's
okay, see. What do we have?
Another 9.8.
Yeah, that's...
it's really good. I love Wonder Woman. I don't know anyone who doesn't, but...
all these books are... any book from 1990 to date, if it isn't a 9.4 or 9.2, 9.4, 9.6, you know, above 9.2, I don't know what the hell the person was doing with the book, so... Okay, what else we got there?
Let's see. We have Edge of Spider-Verse. Gwen Stacy.
Okay, now this is the third printing of Gwen Stacy's first appearance, I believe. And I always like the design covers better than the other covers, to be honest with you. So, I don't know why I don't have the first print, but I do not. But this is in excellent condition.
Looks really good.
Let's see what we got.
9.8.
I'll take that any day of the week, because there are some Avengers books that are coming out right now that have the design variants. Mm-hmm. I remember you telling me you liked those.
Oh, yeah. Too. You can't go wrong with them. They're so great.
So, okay. What else do we have?
All right. Let's see. Ooh, this is one of my favorites. It's Captain America. What makes this one so unique, it has the wraparound cover, too. Which is really nice. Very, really good detail.
Well, that's... Okay, and who's the artist on this?
It is Alex Ross. Can't go wrong with his work.
I love Alex Ross. What more can I say?
Here's the front, if you guys can see it. In the back. Let's see what we got. 9.8.
This is one of those books that I really can't wait to hang up in my comic book room.
It's a good one. I love the detail.
We're filming on a table right inside my sunroom. So maybe sometime we'll film inside my comic book room when we get a chance. I kind of, that's like my sacred area. I don't like people to come in there and look around.
Right, so. It's sacred. It's locked and everything. No one can go in.
That's because I have my coin collection in there,
too. True. Very true.
Okay. What's next, dear?
All right. Oh, this is another good one, Captain America. I love this cover.
That's what you call a great painting.
It's very detailed. Very nice.
And this is Captain America's, 80th anniversary year?
Mm-hmm.
I sent in a bunch of Captain America stuff that I just love.
I was going to say, if you can't tell, we love Captain America over here.
Okay, what do we have?
9.8. This cover is beautiful. We can't go wrong with that.
No.
So much detail, and it's very good.
I don't know if everybody out there likes Captain America like I do, but it's... let's just say Avengers 4 is still... one of my all-time favorites.
All right. Let's keep it going. Let's see. So far, we're doing pretty well.
Yeah.
All right. We have Invincible. Hey, Mo, is any of the one that came out with The Walking Dead, too?
Kirkman,
yes.
Yes.
I knew that name looked Marissa. Familiar. See, I knew it looked familiar. I've heard of it before.
Okay. This is the Larry's limited edition.
I think he's also... Isn't Invincible coming... Like, it's going to have its own TV show soon?
There is an Invincible cartoon coming out. That is right, Marissa.
I heard it.
That's why I sent this in. I thought, what the hell?
All right, you ready to see what we got on this one?
Yeah, well, this is perfect. It's got to be a 9.8. Yeah.
Yep, it's 9.8. I love it. Can't wait for that show to come out.
It is a great... I love the... Okay, well, we'll say in a second. Let's see what else we have in here. Hopefully it's in there, but I'll...
We'll see what we got. All right.
Okay. The Tick.
The Tick.
This is the first limited edition, special edition, limited edition, numbered edition run that they came out with. And he's on the back as well.
You can see.
Again, this book was good. It was well read. How about that? I did have it pressed. A lot of spine ticks, so...
Let's see what we got.
As long as it's above 9, I'm happy.
Yeah, we're at a 9, too. That's really good.
I'm good
with
that.
We'll take it.
Now, we just had Invincible. Now... The 100th issue of The Tick has the Invincible on in the book.
Oh, okay.
And it is If anybody out there has not seen it or read it, pick up the Tick 100, and it is one of the best reads you'll ever want. I mean, it's fantastic. I don't know what else to say. What's next, dear? I'm a big Tick fan. I love the cartoon that was out in the 90s.
Speaking of you being fantastic. A Tick fan, look what else we got.
Okay. Now, this is an identical version of this issue. It's just that they started it, they decided to have the Tick number one, and they started the series. And it was a little bit better, but it was a black cover. Black and white covers, they're both very difficult to get high grades
on. I think I like the black cover better, in my opinion, but...
Well, it does look better, but...
It's more clean.
Let's just see what we got. If it's above a 9, that would be fantastic.
All right. It is a 9.4.
No way. That is amazing.
Way too higher than the white copy.
Do you know, I send a lot of books down to CGC now, and they are erratic, to say the least. You get books back that are graded lower than you think they should be, and then you get books back that are higher than you think they should be. I don't know how this can be higher than the special edition one.
I don't know. Maybe because I'll just say,
CG, thank you for the grade, and I'll just let it go at that. I don't plan on selling it, so it doesn't matter. It's protected in there. And okay, what else we got? How many books left?
We got 3 more.
Okay.
We'll see.
So far, so good.
Yeah, everything's looking good. All right, this is one of my favorites, Hawkeye.
Now, I've got to be honest. I got this about 5-6 years ago in a dollar bin. And... It wasn't in the greatest shape, but I have a guy who cleans and presses books. I thought he did a great job cleaning and pressing it. It was probably, before he got to it, it was probably about a 7, 7.5.
I like the purple detailing on the cover. I love it. It matches really well.
My guy said that he thought that this was going to be an 8.5 or a 9.
All right.
So let's see if he was right or not.
Exactly a 9.0.
It's just a great cover. Issue number 11, the dog cover issue. I don't have that. I would like to get it. So hopefully I'll pick that up. I'm going to a comic book convention, the first one in over a year, up in Cleveland tomorrow. So hopefully... I'll find the dog issue for a reasonable price and pick it up.
That'd be cool.
So, okay, what else we got there, dear?
All right. Another Captain America.
I'm on my Captain America 80th anniversary kick. What can I say?
I like this cover a lot.
That's the 20th anniversary Marvel Knights cover.
I do like it.
Yeah, it's... I love Cap.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with it.
That book's perfect. So yeah. You don't have to look. I can tell you right now, it's got to be a 9.8.
It's a 9.8.
Okay.
It's in great shape.
Yeah, I just... it's perfect. Right. What more can I say? Okay, what else is left?
I think this is our final book here, Milt. That's what it looks like. Let's see what we got. Captain America and the Invaders. Bahama Triangle.
Now, this book is worth absolutely nothing. Nobody wants this book, I guess, but it's Captain America and the Invaders. I've always loved the Invaders. One of my favorite books in my personal collection is the All Winners number 7, which is basically these guys fighting the Japs. And it's in World War II, and it's just a fantastic cover. And this... I just love the cover.
Who did
the cover? Let me see. Oh, well, let's do it the grade is first.
All right. It is a 9.8.
It was a good shape book. Again, it's an 9/8. It's not worth anything to anybody probably but me.
I know you really liked it when you sent it out, so I was waiting for that grade to come back.
Yes. First off, Roy Thomas wrote the story. He does fantastic work when he was doing the Invaders back in the 70s. And this cover was done by Frank Zurcher. And he just did a fantastic job. I don't know what else to say. If I could find, if there was a virgin variant of this without the cap and everything else on there, it would be even better, but there isn't. So I have what I have, and I love them, so.
All right, Mel, that's everything we got in this shipment.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what. That's all for now for the unboxing. We'll continue this video. I am going to be going up to Cleveland. We'll film again when I get back, and we'll add it to this.
That sounds good to me.
Okay, Marissa, thank you for coming over tonight.
Thanks for having me, Mel. It's always a pleasure.
Okay, have you talked to your fiance?
Yep, he's doing good.
Okay.
Love and work as much as you can.
Yeah, he doesn't call his mom and dad anymore, so we have no way of knowing. So, okay, again, talk to you soon.
All right, bye.
Welcome back, everybody. I have returned from the Cleveland Comic Book and Nostalgia Festival. Good time was had by all. Marissa, sorry you had to work. You would have enjoyed it up there, let me tell you.
Yeah, you got some good stuff I can still see, though, so we'll see what
yes,
you got.
Yes, I got a bunch of stuff. So I'll tell you what, let's do this first. Let's show what we bought. Funko Pops. We bought a couple Funko Pops. Now this, what is great about this Wilson Fisk Funko Pop? I really think it's well done. But $11, $9, $3. I can't pass up a $3 Funko Pop. So I got Wilson Fisk. I also picked up the limited edition Man-Thing. One of my all-time favorite characters, I should point out. And in addition, I also, a buddy of mine I ran into up there, bought this for me. And Steve, you know who you are. Thank you kindly, I appreciate it. It is the Stan Lee Street Art Funko Pop. It's kind of neat.
That's cool. I like that.
And in addition, when I go to comic book shows, I really don't need a whole lot of comic books. So I buy a bunch of stuff. One of the things I bought was the classic Batman, 1960s Batman with the Batmobile and Robin in the Batmobile. It's awesome. In addition, I bought the Marvel Heroes Captain America Resin Bank. I love this thing. This is, I should take it out and show everybody. You hold the box?
Yep.
Thank you, dear. Wow. Feel this. This is pretty heavy.
Oh, wow. Looks really nice, though.
It was a good pickup. $25. What the hell?
Really cool.
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
It'll go good with my Captain America collection, which maybe on Cap's birthday. The 80th birthday, I will bring all my Captain America material down and display it for us to review and look at. Now, let's put it right here, though. Now, every time you come, you have to put at least a quarter in the Captain America bag.
That's my fee, huh?
Yeah, it's your fee.
Co-star fee.
I'm going to keep the box, too. I like the box. Okay. Now, I did buy some comics.
Styrofoam everywhere.
Yeah, I know. I hate that. Classic book. Samurai Santa. And what makes this book so good? It is the first professional work done by Jim Lee. I'm not sure whether he did the lines on this one or whether I think he may have just done the artwork, the coloring on this. But it's fun to have the first work done by Jim Lee. And I buy this when I see it because it's only $2. But it's one of those books that I've always loved to cover. And that is the Marvel Superhero Contest of Champions, issue number 1. I just love that issue. And this is a book that I have in my collection already, but it's a pretty crappy copy. And I found a excellent, I would say this is upwards of about an 8, to be honest with you. It is Daredevil, Giant Size Daredevil, Annual number 1. He didn't really have a whole lot of annuals going way back when, but this one is one that he has. Now, I just like this cover, and if you look close, now what do you think, guys? Maybe, I don't know. You gotta straighten your hair more, maybe, and
wear purple.
Wear purple.
There we go.
Hawkeye number 1. Now, I picked this up because it was only $20, and I thought, what the heck, it would be good to add to the collection. And that is the variant of Voices with Miles Morales. I think that is a great draw. And I got Miles Morales, number 23, the basketball variant.
Oh, that one's cool.
Yes.
I like that one. Different. I like it.
My older son, Vince, who's a big basketball guy, would probably like to have that. Now, they are coming out with the Venom issue, where Venom is dunking over top of Miles, but we'll see. And I found this. It was really, 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 really cheap. So I bought it. I got it back graded at a 9.8, and I don't really need it, but I can maybe use it as trade bait for something else, and that is Ultimate Fallout 4, the variant second print, where Miles shows his face on the cover for the first time. And this, I bought because my son wanted an issue with Bat-Hound. And here's Batman 158 with Bat-Hound on the cover. I'm not going to say anything more except it's a classic book. And here's something. I have a very extensive Batman collection going way, way back. Let's just say way, way back. And one of the things I do not have was I have the annuals, but issues 2 and 6 were not in high condition. I was able at the show to find not only number 6 in excellent, probably about 7.5 condition, I was also able to find Batman Annual number 2 in the same condition. Excellent books, and I can get rid of my issues too, my bad issues, I guess. Now, let me take some of these off of here. this is something which I love. And this is the first appearance of the Flintstones in comics.
I like the Flintstones.
The Flintstones, Del Giant, Bedrock, Bedlam. I did not have this. I saw it. I had to have it.
Might as well, right?
I still do not have the Jetsons' first appearance. I have gotten to the point now where I started picking up 1960s TV shows, their first appearances, first episodes, like I Dream of Jeannie number one, Bewitched number one, The Munsters number one. They've all been sent out to be graded, not because they're great grades and high grades, but because I don't want them to be destroyed.
True.
Over the years. Now, I'm a big boxing fan, and one of the books I found was Joe Louis, Champion of Champs. This is from 1947, one of the two. It's in pretty good condition, and what I found inside here was unbelievable. Inside this book are articles clipped from the newspapers back then of Joe Louis winning his last championship defense.
Oh, wow.
Yes, it's... This is awesome. You have to appreciate sports and boxing to appreciate that. I'm also a big baseball fan, and I was able to pick up for $100. That's all. It was more than that, but he let me have it for $100. I've talked to the gentleman who sold this to me a bunch of times, and he's also a baseball fan, and so he understood that this isn't going to be sold to anybody else. This is going to be put in my collection, on my wall, in my man cave. Not in my comic book room, but in my man cave. And this is the Fawcett print Jackie Robinson. It presents phenomenal. It is just a classic, classic book. And I am honored to have that in my collection. So, the last two things I purchased, let me show you the next to last first.
This one's funny.
But it's not funny.
This I think it's
original,
funny.
In the package, napkins, happy birthday, Elf.
I think it's funny.
It is phenomenal. This is the absolute best. I'm a big Elf fan. I just love it. So that goes up there. And then here's something interesting which they had some of, and they have. The guy can apparently do any of these. If you have a comic that you want made into this, you send him the comic and he can, or you tell him which comic it is and he'll be able to find it online. And he has a computer program that will make a woodburn print of it. This is a woodburn print of Detective 27. It is solid wood.
That's one of my favorite things you picked up. It's really cool.
Yes, and it's $25, guys. That's all. $25.
Can't
beat that. Leave in the comments if you're interested in getting some of these, and I'll see what I can do, and I'll have more information on the next show as how you can get in contact. His contact information will be there. If I get a chance, I'll try to put it, at the end of this episode. So that was my day at the Cleveland festival. Good time. Just if I had just come back with the Jackie Robinson, it would have been a day. But to get everything else that I got, it's just fantastic. That's all I have on my end. Please hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and that little ringer thing.
The bell.
And
it's from now on the ringer thing.
Yeah, the ringer thing. We'll have one more segment to the show, and that will be, I've gone up and down the coast during the pandemic, and I've stopped in at a variety of comic book stores, and I've also stopped in at a variety of comic book stores in the Pittsburgh area as well, and we'll have a 2 to 3 minute video coming up on Milt's trips, and I'll show you what some of the different comic book stores look like, and you can let me know whether you like their comic book store, whether you don't, whether you wish you had their comic book store in your backyard, or if I show a comic book store from Georgia and that's your comic book store, let me know. Okay, so let's go on Milt's trips. Here we are at Pittsburgh Comics, in just south of Pittsburgh. It's one of the best stores in the area, and I think everyone's going to like how it's set up. We come in, and here's the latest trade paperbacks over here to the right. Over there is Colin. He's the
working hard
owner and hard worker in the store. We have two dogs in the store. Really friendly, I should point out. Yeah. Hey guys, if we come in and we go to the right, here we have back issues in the boxes in the middle. And then going around the outside, the last several issues of the most recent books that come out. If it is a new issue, that's clearly labeled so everyone knows. Back here we have some hardbacks and other trade paperbacks. We have toys as well, shirts. Lots and lots of back issues. This is just a great store. That is this side of the store. Going to the other side, here's the back issues that are on sale, 50% off. Over here, we have the trade paperbacks and hardbacks, as well as statues throughout the store. Excellent assortment. Here we have the glasses. I really like this Luke Cage. More statues up there. More statues over here. Excellent prices on everything, I should point out, as well as the trade paperbacks. Some more statues in here. A few older books up there. More kids-oriented books down here. Here are the last week's variant covers that came in. And down here is a few of the older books
going back maybe to the 70s or so.
Wish I had older stuff.
Sir, whatever people purchase. Now, if you're in the Pittsburgh area and haven't been to Pittsburgh Comics, here is the card with the address and the hours. Currently, they're not open on Monday, but they're down at 113 East McMurray Road in McMurray, PA, 15317. There's the phone number. If you want to give Colin a call, and their website as well. Let me see what's on the other side of the card. Pittsburgh Comics. The owner, Colin, how long have you been in business now?
14 years.
14 years.
15 in September.
I understand you're going to have a big 50% off sale whenever the 15th anniversary gets here.
We always do something big, yeah.
Okay. Well, again, highly recommended. Excellent store. Anybody have any questions? Please give Colin a call or post a question on the comment section below the YouTube sign. Okay, that's all for now. I'll see everybody later on. Bye. It's the end of the world as we know it.
Mountain City, then a light, Leonard Bernstein, Leonard Grass, Nap, Lenny, Bruce, and Lester Banks, birthday party.